For many generations, Luton has been the centre of the hat industry in the UK. Dating back to the 17th century, Lutonians have been making hats for all sorts of people, the rich and the poor, and even royalty. Luton experienced an economic boom in the 19th century, when the straw plaiting and wool felt trade reached a peak. The hat making industry has been shrinking lately, and there are fewer handmade hat makers that are still in Luton. Walter Wright is one of those companies that have still survived and are still making hats to this day. Philip Wright is the director of Walter Wright and designed some of their hats.
How big would you say the hat industry is today in Luton and in Britain as a whole?
We influence, as a town, Luton has sadly, as a result of COVID, the lockdowns, the massive effects it's had globally to the market, sadly Luton has lost another epic manufacturer, so I believe. It's not, say, set in stone yet, but I think it's occurring as we speak.
Do you think hat designing is an art form?
It is an art form because, like retail, is a combination of science, the mathematics, and the art. Now, so it's a combination of two. It's art, but it has to employ science as well. Now, we would call the scientific aspect of the art within the hat trade, the scientific aspect is called experience.
Only six block makers remain in the world, with one of them being based in Luton. They are called Boone & Lane. The Wright family has been making hats for over 300 years now, and Philip is the fourth generation to work at the original site of the factory.
So, what do you know about Luton's hat history?
I know that Luton has a history of hats. It's got hat factories in the town right now. And as far as I know, they've been here for a couple of hundred years at least. And I know that the football team, the local football team, is nicknamed the Hatters. So yeah, Luton's famous for hats.
We went round a local Luton campus to ask a sole question. This is what someone from the general public had to say on the matter.
Someone that might be crazy or someone that might be kind of eccentric.
Somebody who is totally bonkers and does crazy things.
Maybe it's a bit crazy, a bit out there.
I think it's someone who is a little bit crazy, a little bit fun, a little bit out there, a little bit unique.
Mad as a Hatter comes from when they used to make hats, the way they used to make hats, and it was some kind of glue or substance they used for bending the hats, which had, I think, mercury in it, and that gave them, over time, it sent them mentally ill, and so you if you were a hatter, you might get mad. So that was where it unfortunately came from.